item. It will address depression in adolescents. And if you are uncomfortable with anything that I am saying in any moment, please feel free to leave. And then return afterwards. So it's just one talk. I guess like all TED Talks, I will begin with a statistic. And that statistic is every 3 minutes, 5 people commit suicide. And by the time I walk off stage, 17 people would have died. And in another life, I could have been one of those people. When I first heard the word depression, I didn't know what it meant. But as time passed by, acquaintances turned to friends, and day by day, side by side, depression became the closest friend I had in my life. It was always going to tell me I messed up, and always going to tell me that my best isn't good enough. And the weight of my failures and flaws and weaknesses would crush me until I couldn't breathe. And I would push people away to see who really cares. The loneliness haunting, trust always lacking. But my sense of self-worth has always been low. Being the cause of disruption at home, I would stare at my reflection, hating everything that I see. And I realized that everything I think would end up killing me. And like most people I know, this started with family. When the parents parted ways, I was blamed for discrepancy. You're too much like her, you're the reason he hates me. And my idea of love, a happy family, and confidence just disappeared. But then again, it doesn't matter where it came from. It matters that it stayed. Now, over 2 years ago was the first time I wanted to die. It was also my 14th birthday. The day had gone just fine. It was spent with friends who I am now so thankful to call mine. But coming home and believing that they are worth more, that I did not deserve them. I lay in bed till 3 a.m. crying my eyes out because I knew I couldn't handle it. I couldn't handle comparing myself to them in every way, shape, and form. I couldn't handle how fragile I was or how easy I would break, and I couldn't handle living with or being a monster. I wasn't a good enough daughter or a good enough friend. My looks weren't good enough, my grades weren't good enough, my brain is not good enough. You see, what went on inside my mind didn't correspond to work with the daily grind, because I was a bottle of uncertainty, psychosis, and insecurity. When picked up, I was only destined to fall. When shaken, everything inside me became a tornado, wrecking chaos into everything I touch and feel. I would empty my insides so small there was only room for butterflies, and decorate my plate to make it look like I had ate and exercised to the point where I would faint simply because I listened to what the devils had to say. I was trapped in my bubble of self-consciousness, feeling like my chest was going to explode, like my lungs were going to collapse. I carved the word worthless into the armature that is my body, purposely trying to feel pain, because I felt so much of it, I felt nothing at all. I would starve myself for days, paint my skin with a blade, sit alone with smoke in my lungs, suicide consuming my brain. And what is worse is that I would hate myself for it. I hate what I had become. I was drunk on my depression. I let it take over my life and ruin me. Because depression is a tidal wave. It starts small and then destroys all sanity, judgment, and hope. Meltdowns will come in surprise floods of anxiety. I was sinking in the depths of my fears and desolation, with the only comforting feeling in the world being staring down at the concrete, letting addiction come over me. It is seeing that I'm drowning, but not knowing if I ever wanted to breathe. Where am I supposed to hide these thoughts of mine? For everything I feel has been stigmatized to the point where I feel like I have to keep my demons inside, my wretched mind, but then that time, I thought it was best to end my life. Here comes the part where I'm supposed to write about recovery. This was actually quite hard for me, because when I first wrote this about 6 months ago, I had been only 4 months clean. Not a single suicidal thought disguised as a daydream, but I relapsed. I welcomed the darkness back into my fragile and broken soul, but a relapse is nothing to be ashamed of. This nothing to be ashamed of. I made it once before, and if it isn't clear, I tried again. For all I know, this is always going to be a part of me, a shadow forever following, thoughts forever lurking at the back of my sick mind, but I am alive, and these scars don't make me me. I am me because of the way my voice is shaking, and the way I fix my hair every 5 seconds, and my hopes and my dreams, everything in between. But I cannot forget about this. The madness that has defined 2 years of my life, I am coming out stronger. With the ability to notice others' emotions, more sure of my ability to survive, aware of the shitty people, and aware of the great. I now know what hope looks like, and I will fight myself to find myself. And if I stumble, I have people to smack me in the face and tell me I'm insane. But I am loved, and it is okay to be sad. Venting, movies, poetry, music, friends, family, whatever makes you calm, do more of it. Petty relationships, familial and societal expectations, the never-ending pressure from school are not worth risking your sanity. And I don't know if you've been told this, but darling, your mental health comes first. It doesn't matter if it will take a week or a month or a year. And they say it gets better, it's so hard to believe, but it's true. I know. I am the only thing I will have in my life permanently, so I better take damn care of myself. And if you think it is impossible to find hope, just know you're not alone, because there are kids just like me and like you, all over the world, all over the country, and all over this godforsaken town. You just need to look hard enough. And before you come to any conclusions, this is not just me. This is not just my story. This is the story of the broken, the beaten, and the damned. A sneak peek of all the suffering, stress, and scars represented in one story. This is for the kids who are too scared to try. It's for the kids who are afraid of their own mind. It's for the kids who look at themselves in the mirror and cannot help but cry. It's for the kids who wear long sleeves in the summer, and for the kids who tread the waters of their mental illness with the weight of the world on their shoulders, bringing them down, but they keep going, whether they like it or not. But then again, this is also for the kids who get a little bit of marker on their wrists and decide to keep drawing scars because they think it is funny. It is for the kids who drag scissors across their arm instead of the frog they are supposed to dissect, because they want to know why people cut themselves and then laugh when they don't get it. This talk is for me. It's for you. It's for the parents who do not understand, and for the angels who do. It is for Patch, August, Grace, Lucky, Caitlin, Cage, suffocated Eli, Band-Aids, and Bravery, dazed and confused. And if you think that through all of this, that people like me are weak, you do not understand the point of this piece. Because the world is a dark place, and sometimes it is hard to see the sunshine. But I know what I want to live for, and I refuse to get in the way of myself.